Hi friends, today we are going to configure multiple area OSPF router. As in first part we have seen that how to configure in a single area OSPF. In second part this we will be intensely looking into multiple areas like area 1 and 2 where routers are already configured. For example, I have already configured in area 1 to showcase you how it will configure communicate. However, in area 2 I have only configured the basic static routing. So static routing means that I have given IP addresses to each and every router. Right now I am going to configure in front of you how exactly multiple areas are be configured, and it is quite simple. First we will go to router A. And meanwhile what I am going to do that router E, which is this, you able to see what exactly going happening in router extreme end of the network, what exactly going to happen when I make changes in router A. So that is more desirable to look into and understand how exactly they are interacting. So getting quickly into what exactly I am going to do. So config T, and for you who does not know what exactly tool I am using, I am using Cisco packet tracer. It is totally free and you can use it. So it is a quite good software, as well as you can use NS3, which I will use in other videos to display same kind of, but with lot of other information. So right now we are going to add again, reminding you that I am right now going to enter wildcard mask, and it means that I care means I exactly was the exact match, but this does not last. I does not want the exact match, whereas Cisco says that everything should be in exact match what they recommend. And area 2, that is more important in this part because we are right now configuring this part of the router world. That's it. It is done. And we just go out. Save our configuration. So router A has been done. And router F. Meanwhile we look into that any mic changes or it pickups the link. So router F I am going to be configuring. Okay, I have not saved the link. Right now I have saved. And so everything will be same, and router ID. In this case, if you are wondering why I not allotted router IDs to previous router, the simplest reason was that earlier router I have already given the router ID. So next time I do not have to give a router ID is singly identified one particular router. So this router would be, I am giving 8.8.8. And host 10.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0. Wi-Fi, then area to again and see. Router B is the middle router in between area 0, and the last is G. Command is quite simple. You have to just focus and understand what exactly it means. So router ID should be different for individual. If you are giving from your end. Configuring things, so that is more important. So right now we are doing G. We are more concentrated on B. It is not B. So let's go ahead and do this also. If it does not pick up, we suddenly our ping will not reflect, and it could be while mask. I'm still there. Should it has thrown error, and you should always, and as you can see this particular arrow thing, it will show you where exactly the error has happened most probably. So you should know what this error message trying to tell you, that there is something wrong in this particular command line. So where exactly and how you going to do that? That is system. We are out of the system. Saving the config, and we are going to see being that is going to let us know how good our networking will be set. So being the extreme end of the router. Router E is there. So we are quite successful in this, and as you can see that it is able to ping successfully the router E, which is extreme end of this diagram. At the same time, from G to E, I'm going to right now ping from E, which is the extreme end of the router, and see it is going to ping this extreme end of the router or not. See, we are still quite successful in setting up the multiple here router. So that is how it is done, and you just have to remember try to understand what exactly is going on. Ahead of these videos, I am going to create more videos on OSPF protocol right now to get you a deeper understanding of what exactly and how it is going on. Right now I am using, as I previously mentioned, that I am using Cisco packet tracer, and it is quite doing its work wonderfully. After that, I might create videos on GNS3 and how add-on products you can use on that. So for meanwhile, this is the multiple OSPF router configuration, and I hope that you have learned from this, and thank you for watching my video. Thank you.